So luckily the homie from Phoenix saved Fuck the Police. Was there any hesitation? Because at that time, like, a song like that is just absolutely unheard of. Was there hesitation by anyone in the group once you presented? Was everyone really just like, let's get this shit?
Yeah, it was hesitation. Dre, he didn't want to do the song because he had an ankle bracelet on and he was doing weekends at the county. They was making him.
he didn't want to get punished.
He was like, man, fuck. He said, man, I ain't. See, I got to deal with these fucking sheriffs, man, every weekend. And I ain't going in there with a song like this, man. So, no. So I didn't think it was going to get made until, you know, months later when we was, you know, doing the record. Because we had did some solo records, you know, before. We did Dope Man. We did Gangsta Gangsta. So we was going to do another solo record, which was Fuck the Police. And he was like, not that one. So, after all that blew over, after he, you know, kind of, you know, had that case dismissed or whatever, he was down to do it because he didn't have to see him every weekend. I wrote the song because I was mad he would have to go in on the weekends because he was our way into every party in the city. You know, I'm like, we were Drake, nigga. What's up? Let's go in. You know what I mean? Without him, it was like, hey, who y'all with? We was with Dre last week. He's like, it ain't last week, homie. Don't get to the back of the line. So our partying was on E. You know what I'm saying? We was house partying. I'm like, man, this house party shit is dangerous. You know what I'm saying? We need to go back to some clubs, like skating rinks and shit like that, you know?
And Dre was the get in free card.
Straight up.
When in the history of civilization have we ever heard our legends be able to recite and talk about what they went through, and then there was a visual attached to it along with audio? I don't think we've ever had that. Anytime any of these dudes talk, Ice Cube, Dr. Dre, you know, Ren, Yella, Arabian Prince, I'm always locked in because, you know, one day we all move on. These dudes are going to move on as well. And we're going to be extremely grateful that they were as open in sharing these stories like this. Thank you, Q, for that. And thank you, Dre. I want a lot of y'all to pay attention to this if you're an entrepreneur or if you make music, because I really want you to think about, first of all, I'm sweating profusely, okay? Walked outside, go get the mail, came back, set up everything, got these lights on me, and, you know, washed my face, put my moisturizer on, you know, did all types of stuff trying to be cute and all that shit, and I'm sweating like, you know, shit. So forgive me. But I want y'all to really pay attention to this video and how your fear can cripple you. And when you have something that lives inside of you so deep, you got to get it out. A lot of y'all are sitting on shit that could change your life. And I'm going to talk about what I've witnessed, how this has helped me, and what you could take away from Dr. Dre and Ice Cube right here. Before you do that, you got to make sure you watch this entire video. That helps me big time. Hit like, hit share, comment, save. All that helps the algorithm. Make sure you follow. Make sure you subscribe.
My ducks, my swans, welcome to the pod.
My name is Dorian from group82university.com, and right here we got Ice Cube talking about how Dr. Dre didn't want to make Fuck the Police. Now, you know, I know for a lot of y'all that are really young, sweat keeps coming, ain't stopping. You don't understand how monumental this was. See, back then, you know, people were cussing on records, but they weren't cussing like this. And a message where you are saying fuck an authoritative figure, specifically young black dudes, not rock dudes, but black dudes, you know, in the late 80s, that is extremely scary. And that is tough territory. But because they were completely authentic and it was rooted in social conscience, I think that's why so many people connected with it. And it was a sentiment that a lot of people connected with. I don't know anybody that likes the police like that. Let's say want to be a police, or, you know, they're just a police groupie. And that's why the song took off the way it did, but it almost didn't happen. See, when you're sitting on something so good and it's so passionate and the world needs to hear it, there's an energy that bubbles up inside of you. And I have had those moments in my life. You know, I had those moments when I was in college and I was running for office for union board. I had those moments when I was getting into college basketball coaching, trying to get to the NBA. I also had this moment when I was going to my music career. And there was things that was bubbling up inside of me that I have to get out. And I'm actually going through a moment right now, but I'm not telling y'all what it's for. Y'all will see later on. But you know, when you have that, you gotta get it out. And this can be scary as shit. I mean, you think about them. These dudes was 20 years old talking about fuck the police. They had no money. They barely had a lawyer. They didn't have nothing. You know, they were putting everything on the line. They were putting their livelihoods on the line. Police could have killed them and said it was a gang murder, you know, and mass NWA or some real dope gang that Eazy-E was using to front his drug operation. Could have just completely flipped a switch on them, but they didn't. They didn't do that. They didn't care about that. They went with what was inside them because the world needed to hear it. And look what happened. Look at all the positive that came out of that. Look at the conversations that came out of that. Look at the social issues that were exposed in the inner inner cities that a lot of people didn't know about or they were ignoring to acknowledge until this song came out. Once Rodney King was assaulted by those officers, all of this stuff came back to NWA talking about fuck the police, and people were like, damn, we need to really examine what's going on. Now, a lot of things haven't changed the past 25, 30 years, but I want to focus on how fearless they were. And that's how you got to be with whatever it is. Whatever business idea you have, you got to go after. You got to do that shit. You know, whatever content idea you have, you got to go after. You got to do that shit. A lot of y'all don't be feeling like filming, and I get it. You know, I didn't really feel like filming today, but I know this message needs to get out there, and I know it's something that's going to help push my brand, and it's something I'm passionate about, something I want to talk about, something that's inside of me that God wants me to tell y'all. You need to get after it. You need to trust your gut. You need to trust your instincts, which a lot of y'all don't want to do. And all that comes from insecurity in society where they're trying to scare you into behaving a certain way. The sheriffs are trying to scare Dr. Dre into behaving a certain way, which almost scared Ice Cube into not putting a song out, where Ice Cube actually threw it away. But because they were fearless and they did it anyway, look at what happened. Fear is a part of the journey. Fear is a hurdle we all go through. Fear is a difference maker. It's a filter. It deciphers between who really wants it and who doesn't. Everybody who is successful has experienced fear. Everybody. They just don't let fear stop them. A lot of you are fearful about something you do every single day, or maybe you're fearful about your business or whatever it is, but you let fear get in your way. Why? What are you afraid of? Your life changing? Ain't that the point? What was NWA afraid of? The police harassing them? Systemic racism? Not having money? They were already in this position. They were already in this spot. So what do they have to lose? Nothing. What do you have to lose with your social media content? Nothing. What do you have to lose with your business idea? Nothing. You have absolutely nothing to lose. So what do you have to be fearful of besides fear itself? What was that in? Coach Carter? Maybe? The movie's corny as hell, by the way. Don't be afraid, man. Well, let me rephrase that. There's nothing wrong with being afraid. Just don't let the fear cripple you or debilitate you. Look at what it did for NWA. What can it do for you? If you somebody who's ready to get past that fear, you make music, you on Instagram, you click that link up top. You on YouTube, you click the link in the box. Go buy our class, How to Market Your Music on Social Media. Shit can change your life. I'm Out the Pond. Y'all stay true.
Here we go again. Steady arguing. I swear to God, girl, I need this to end. I'm out here on the road doing 100 shows. And every cent I make, I'm sending back home.
Group82University.com.